bienvenidos to our annual banquet. Not many school districts have had the historic and successful school year that Laredo ISD is close to completing this May. Just think about it. In 1 month, we're going to be graduating close to 1,500 students, and we're going to send them on their way to college, start their careers, or join the military. And this year, we also had one of our schools awarded the 2018 National Blue Ribbon title by the United States Department of Education. That was Calas Elementary. Wonderful, wonderful memory there. And in addition, we have four elementary schools nominated for the 2019 Blue Ribbon Award. We are the only school district in the entire state of Texas that has four schools nominated for this prestigious honor. So, whether you impacted these students when they were little ones or when they became young men and women, this success is made possible by all of you all here gathered today. Our employees of the classrooms, the cafeterias, inside of the buses, and our offices, anywhere where our employees faithfully serve. So tonight we are gathered here in this very elegant reception hall to honor LISD's very best. Our retirees and our nominees for Teacher of the Year and Paraprofessional of the Year. We have lots and lots of recognitions coming up tonight, but before we begin, I ask that you please rise for the invocation to be offered by one of our retirees, Mrs. Magdalena Bazan, librarian at J.A. Calas Elementary School. Ms. Bazan?
Dedicated Laredo Independent School District employees who vigorously serve our students. Heavenly Father, we are extremely grateful for all the gifts that each one of us has been bestowed on throughout our careers. We ask that you anoint us in this next chapter of our lives. Give us the ability to embrace new challenges without apprehension or fear. We pray that you continue to give us wisdom, guidance, compassion, and humility to serve all our students and our community. We ask them in your name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Mrs. Bazan. And please remain standing for the national anthem, which will be performed by the Sigaloa High School Orchestra under the direction of Mr. Tomas Aguilar, the Sigaloa High School Orchestra. Department.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of
Thank you, Ms. Bassan, and thank you, Ms. Hernandez. And a big round of applause once again for the Cigarron High School Orchestra and Ms. Bassan. Before we go any further, I would like to introduce to you some very special guests joining us tonight. We have with us the President of the Laredo ISD Board of Trustees, the Honorable Hector Tito Garcia. Also with us is our Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Silvia Guerra Rios. And now here to greet you on behalf of the Board of Trustees is our Board President, community leader who has served on our board for 9 years, a product of LISD schools, a respected business and civic leader. Please help me welcome our Board President, Mr. Hector Tito Garcia.
Thank you very much. Thank you for the great introduction. Flores, I do want to congratulate you on outstanding group of kids. I think of all the events that we have during the year that we have to go and present at or talk at, or whatever it is, I think this is probably one of the ones that I have mixed feelings about, because there's so many people that are retiring. And when you retire, it's somebody that's part of your family that's going to relax. They've given all they can. They want to have some fun for themselves. I used to tell my father the same thing. Dad, be tired. Enjoy yourself. I'm glad those of you that are working with us, that have given everything you have to our school district to make LISD the place to be. We are very proud of all our employees. The district, 8 years ago, 10 years ago when we entered, was some kind of, I would say, not functioning the way we wanted it to function. I think in the last 10 years, the school district has gone to another level. And I think it's because of the leadership of our superintendent and her staff, but it's because of the people that are sitting at every table. Those of you that are retiring and those of you are still with us, thank you for everything you've done. Thank you for keeping everything real and making sure that the students go first. We thank you, the parents thank you, the rest of the board thank you. God bless you, enjoy retirement, and I look forward to retiring very soon too. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Garcia. Our superintendent is finishing up her second year as our chief, and it's been a year filled with all kinds of achievements in the classroom. It's my pleasure to introduce our instructional leader, Dr. Silvia Rios.
Good evening. Bienvenidos para todos que nos acompañan en esta noche. Esta noche es muy especial para todos que están aquí, porque es un tiempo para reflejar en todo lo bonito que se ha hecho en todos estos años, así como dice el presidente. I just want to congratulate all of the people who are here today. And I want you to think about something that is so, so important. I was looking at the names of the retirees, and I was thinking of all the announcements of things that have happened under those particular educators or those particular individuals who worked in our department. And I thought, wow, this person is leaving. I remember when this particular award was won by that school. I remember when that teacher did this or that for their students. You are so important, whether you happen to be a teacher, you are someone who works in one of the departments as a support staff. You are the reason that this school works. Yes, we have leaders and we've got people with titles, but I'm looking at our individual that's graduating to another level. I'm retiring, what I mean by that, is moving on to another level of experience in your life. I'm thinking of all the students that you impacted. So if you were to sit here and you were to remember remember every single child that went into your classroom, or that you helped serve at the cafeteria, or that you did something special for them. You would be amazed at the impact that you have upon our students and upon our school. All of you who are in the orchestra, thank you so, so much. You are such a wonderful reflection of the good that comes from being a teacher, of the good that comes from being a leader, of the good that comes from having a district that supports the fine arts. Thank you so, so very much. This weekend, there was a lot of athletic competitions, right? And there were students that rose to the challenge. Not only did they rise to the challenge, they were exemplary and brought home some very precious awards. That's the same in every single thing. We just finished taking the star. We got our scores back. If you are a teacher and you taught a tested grade, raise your hand. If you are retiring, if you are a teacher, period, and you tested somebody in third through eighth grade, raise your hand. Raise your hand. So, so very proud of you. So very proud of you. Because we know that it takes a lot of work. And we know that it takes a lot of support from your principals, from staff that's in your campuses. So I just want to be able to wish you the very, very best in the next few steps of your lives. Enjoy your families, enjoy the next challenges that you're going to face, but I will tell you one thing that I'm asking you to do. Never stop making a difference in the lives of those around you, because you do. You make a difference in so many ways that are innumerable. So with this being said, God bless, and on behalf of the Laredo Independent School District family, enjoy your retirement, and if you are here for an award, enjoy that too. Just a few more weeks, we're gonna be through with testing, and you're gonna be ready for summer, but I know the work never ends. So God bless, and thanks.
Thank you, Dr. Rios. And I will take a break from our program and give you time to enjoy your dinner and each other's company. Dinner will be served shortly, and don't forget to visit our dessert table, which will open after dinner. Okay, we're back on our program, and I hope everyone has enjoyed their dinner. This event tonight has been the effort of many departments and individuals, beginning with the staff from the LISD Office of Communications. So I would like to publicly recognize and thank Mimi Valdez, Bobby Treviño, Claudia Rodriguez, Claudia Sandoval, Sam Mendes, Mario Perez of the Printing Department, and David Flores from ITD. Folks, please stand up and take a bow. Thank you for all of your help. I know you work very hard. We also have the assistance of the Human Resources Department, especially Diana Martinez. There you are, Diana. Thank you, Diana. And Bonnie Martinez, Assistant Superintendent Rachel. Oralia Santana in the business office, I think she deserves a huge round of applause. Thank you, Oralia. Please go to her thanks. She stole all our tickets and took reservations, and the LISD Police Department for helping us with security. We're going to continue our program, and we're going to begin by honoring our retirees who have dedicated their careers to serving the needs of our students. Diana and ladies, would you all like to come up front and help? And we're going to begin by lining up our retirees. Yes. And retirees, you know who you are, retirees, if you all line up here to my left.
I can now.
Thank you.
indeed a pleasure for me to begin this evening by introducing our retirees for the 2018-2019 school year who are here with us this evening. I want to give you a heartfelt thank you for your service to the school district and wish you well in your retirement. This is a bittersweet day for us. While we are happy for you, we are sad because we're going to miss you. Your efforts have made LISD what it is today. You helped our students realize their dreams, but please remember that the doors of LISD are always open to you. You can come back as substitutes. We hope you will come back to visit us often and perhaps volunteer in our classrooms. Retirees, after you accept your reward, we ask that you please proceed to the staircase for a group photo. Let us begin with employees who have worked in the district between 10 and 25 years. Beginning with Mr. Antonio Hinojosa, he is retiring with 11 years of service from the police department. Mr. Jesus Salazar from Division of Operations, retiring with 15 years of service. Maria Cruz Cabrera from Cigarroa High School, 16 years of service.
Son-in-law and daughter.
years of service.
Thank you. Santa Maria Elementary School, 35. Ms. Olga Ortiz, Santa Maria Elementary School, 35 years of service. Griselda Hidrobo, Lara Academy, 35 years of service. Leticia Martinez, Caguas Elementary School.
Paraprofessional And at this time, I'd like to invite Mr. Oscar Perez, who is our Assistant Superintendent for Student Safety and Compliance, to come and announce the nominees and winners for Instructional Support Paraprofessional of the Year.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Ms. Castillon. It is definitely my honor to introduce the nominees and winner for Instructional Support Paraprofessional of the Year. I'm going to ask that you please stay up front for a group photo, and the nominees are from Antonio Bruni Elementary School, Debbie D. Garza.
Ryan Elementary School, Teresita Andrea Mesa.
Sanchez Ochoa Elementary, Yesenia Garcia. From Santa Maria Elementary School, Ms. Perla Johnson. From Santo Niño Elementary School, Amanda Amy Carmona. Sigaroa High School, Sylvia Valdez. Garcia Early College High School, Alicia Gonzalez. FS Lara Academy, Ms. Samantha Garza. Thank you. She replies, "Of course, what can I do?" Her attention to detail makes her work stand out. She has created an atmosphere conducive to learning, and she makes time to listen to all her students. She is friendly, customer service driven, and always promotes respect for others. She works harmoniously with teachers and staff. She has already set a goal for next year, and that is to top all of her school's accomplishments from this year. She is entrusted with keeping track of 37,976 books, which makes her a very organized person. She sets up interesting displays that catch the students' attention, and she makes sure that all her books are returned to the library. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me congratulate our 2019 Instructional Support Paraprofessional of the Year, Ms. Sunshine Garcia.
Elementary. Ana Maria Magaña, Heights Elementary.
Candy Ramirez,
Tanya High School.
She executes her duties with accuracy, efficiency, and competency. She maintains her files in an organized manner and maintains confidentiality, which has established her as a trustworthy person. She wears many different hats throughout the day, from receptionist to trainee. For many future employees, she is the first point of contact at LISD. She updates job descriptions, screens employee applications, posts job vacancies online, and sets up interviews. She has been with our district for 18 years. And she stands for LISD by being loyal, supportive, and dynamic. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a big round of applause for our 2019 Clerical Operational Support Paraprofessional of the Year, our Assistant Human Resources Officer, Ms. Rosaura Garza.
Felicidades, Rosada. And now I'd like to call up our Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction, Dr. Gerardo Cruz, to the podium to continue.
From Vidal and Treviño School of Communications in
Fine Arts, Sean Gaynor. She connects math concepts to real-world situations, such as exchanging vessels to dollars. And although her personality is calm and quiet, in the classroom she is enthusiastic, passionate about her lessons, propelling her students' confidence in math. She dances in the class and encourages students to share brains and work in pairs. She uses visuals and interactive PowerPoint presentations. Her assignments are visually appealing, rich in content and broken up into sections from the basic to the most challenging. She has high standards for her students and believes that anything is possible. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me congratulate the LISD's 2019 Secondary Teacher of the Year from Martin High School. Congratulations, Ms. Alasua. And now we move on to the nominees for the LISD Elementary School Teacher of the Year. From Bruni Elementary School, Maritza Garcia. Thank you.
From Farias Elementary School, Dalia Ibarra. From Didier Char Elementary School, Sader Alacor. From Heights Elementary School, Maria Tejerina. From Line Decker Elementary School, Gabriela Rodriguez. From K. Targer Elementary School, Raul Montiel. Zachary Elementary School, Jamie Christina Ortiz. And now a few words about this year's Elementary School Teacher of the Year. This educator had wanted to be a teacher since she was 5 years old. She would teach her dolls and play school with friends and family. As time passed, the dream stayed very much alive and became a reality as she was inspired by her teachers. In 2013, she was hired by LISD as a science teacher. She became head science teacher in 2016 and student council sponsor, which has given her the opportunity to improve the school's culture and create stronger bonds between the children and their families. She teaches her students to take care of their little piece of the world and become responsible citizens. She teaches them skills that they can transfer to the real world. She believes that all students have a future and it's in their hands to make what they want out of it. One of her favorite lessons involves electrical circuits, working hands-on with wires, batteries, motors, light bulbs, and switches. This lesson teaches them about working as a team. The look of satisfaction and accomplishment on their faces is priceless to this teacher. This teacher wants her students to know that no matter where they come from, they are safe, respected, and cared for at our schools. Please put your hands for the 2019 LISD Elementary Teacher of the Year from J.C. Martin.
Un fuerte aplauso para nuestras ganadoras.